Okay, so I got a little bit of time. Show you some changes. I rebuilt the ice farm. I improved the delay clock a little bit that I showed in a previous video. I vastly improved the design of the wheat farm and some things different with the grinder and that kind of stuff. I'll try to run through stuff as fast as I can. Wither farm. So this is the design I came up with way back when it was first possible. I got half slabs above standing water. Snow blocks in front of it. You hit this switch and sticky pistons pull it down, letting the water flow, and it covers the whole area in water. And then it freezes. As you can see, that froze already. I use this, and I don't use dispensers because there are just a multitude of problems with using dispensers that could go into all of them. But just take my word for it, this is the only way to build this farm to make it 100% efficient. This was not my design here idea. Just pushes up blocks in the center, so because ice only forms to a block, so that makes it all the ice freeze that much quicker. So I borrowed that idea. All right, and that's pretty much this. So I'm gonna run to back to the base. It's about 14,000 blocks that way. So I'll just cut and get back to the nether there and show you the wither farm on the way. Okay, so I made the trip. I'm back in the nether and I just got gun running for my life because I got attacked by a dozen wither skeletons. I'm on the lower levels. This has all been half slabbed, so the only thing that can spawn down here now are slimes. And let me see if I can get ooh, blazes too. Okay, looks like some of them have despawned. Ah, how's that for a shot? Alright. What, I didn't kill him? Or something? So this isn't going very well. At all. There's one problem. There's another problem. Oh, another skeleton over there. I am burning myself. No, don't die. Ho. All right. Ugh. Well, so much for a quick video, huh? And there's a blaze over there. But anyway, the Wither Farm. There is some misinformation on the internet. There's a tutorial out there that I watched that said they only spawn on crossroads. So I started out doing that, and then I quickly discovered no, that's not true. They spawn pretty much anywhere. I have yet to see a spot where they didn't spawn. So what I did was I leveled it off, and it said various buildings, tall buildings, but I made it all level so I could see exactly where they spawn. Whoops, I thought I was gonna get out of the way in time. Oh, okay. That was weird. And I slabbed underneath, and I'm going to slab any netherrack below. I haven't gotten to it yet, where they can spawn, because I want to get the entity count to where they can only spawn here. So I got these little deals. Anyway, I slabbed, for example, this hallway going off there. That was slabbed off. And the slabs all came from the buildings that I shaved off here. So, if you're going to make a wither farm, I suggest doing it kind of similar to what I have here. And forget that video because that was just one spot that they spawned, and it worked for him because he deleted everything in the nether but that, so they had no choice to spawn in that one area. But definitely, the more area you have, and they spawn a certain distance from you, you're way better off. See, all this here should probably be slabbed because pigmen, they spawn down there, and that's just one less entity you can have. Ah, that wither despawned that was over there. So this is what has been successful for me. Went through a couple picks, I guess. This all is going to be done here. This will be fence posts for two reasons. One, the withers can't jump up on top and do that little trick that they like to do. And the other is to prevent if I get hit by a ghast ball or a blaze or something out, or pigment even, I don't get knocked over the edge. It can still happen, but it's pretty rare. So anyway, this isn't very scientifical, but this is what works. Surface area, keep it flat where, so you can see and you go directly to them. You don't have to run up and down stairs, slab everything below. And that's pretty much it. So let's run back to the base quick. Okay, what's new in the base? Let's run quick as we can. The delay that I made in, I think it was last video or the one before, something like that. Slight change. The comparators coming out, I took off two pieces of redstone off of each one so then I could lower the block count. So this is smaller by however many blocks I took out and four pieces of redstone total. And the reason is I just made that repeater on the clock full on, so this clock runs slower. So I get a lot of my delay from this now. It doesn't have to all be blocks. So the delay highly customizable and now 4 blocks cheaper. Let's see what else? Oh yeah, slight change. Oh, you can hear the chicken jukebox is back. There's a tutorial in the tutorial section in a. On the channel shows you how to build that. It's down below. It's got chickens in it and it's far enough away so you don't have to hear them. But if you do come down in this hole right here, you'll be able to hear the chickens. And that was a judgment call because we wanted the maximum area where you can still hear them playing the harp music. And we decided that this is just a small factor that you can hear the chickens when you step into here. Now, this I changed. Hoppers are pretty cheap, especially with infinite iron. So I just put two more hoppers. Really cuts down on the amount of loot that sprays out. Some of it still sprays out here, as you can tell. It's F3 to the south. The loot, almost all the loot launches to the south when you hit a mob. And I put solid blocks here to try to limit how much, and it may or may not have limited it. But went back with glass just for looks. But I think what happens is the items maybe don't spawn directly on the mobs, but a distance away because they seem to go through any blocks that I have here and some still escape. Of course, I could just put a hopper there. Oh yeah, I did try a wall of hoppers too, but they still go through the hoppers, so they're unstoppable for now. Well, I have one more thing to add here. I had told you the height of the water source for the fall damage. Well, that's changed. I lowered it by five, maybe six blocks, something like that. Because with the beacon block, there's one set for strength two. So now they have a lot more health. So absolutely none of them die when they fall. But it would be really hard to kill them. You couldn't kill them by hand, then it would just take too long. But with that beacon block, it's a one-hit kill for everyone. So now no mobs are wasted. So that works out very well. I added more hoppers here. Every once in a while, an item would fly out of there and land like over here or something. So I just encased it more. So when you kill the golems here, you're guaranteed to get all their iron. You don't have to wait around or anything. Like I said, hoppers are cheap, right? Why not use them up? These two under here, the glass, under the glass, obviously they're not going to get any items in them. They're just a transfer to this chest from the other hoppers. Works really good. Flying Z is doing a little bit of excavating around the base. He's got something going. The wheat farm, I improved this quite a bit. It uses light to uproot the wheat. Not my idea. I borrowed it. But I have three dispensers. You see a lot of people doing that. And I have the one on the top pointing down for the bone meal. And the new and improved feature here is one of the feeds going to the dispenser. It's slowed down by one repeater. It has to be in order for the glowstone lamp to work. So now that glowstone lamp flickers. I'll show you this briefly. So this is now server ready. The leg associated with the server doesn't break the machine like it does with the pistons designs. So you can hit this and you can go to town getting wheat. Very little waste of bone meal. As you can see, that light is flickering. And otherwise, it would uproot it. If it was just purely dark in here, it would uproot it instantly, and you would have probably half the return on it. Whoops, that was the wrong thing. Let's see, I don't think I showed you this. It's nothing really special down here. This is the cattle farm. They're way down below here, so as to we get no lag. There was probably three times more than this. My partner went on a meat spree. Yeah, so they're far enough, same principle as in the Gollum farm. Getting far enough away so you don't have to get any kind of lag off of them. This door is here because the baby cows can climb ladders. The chill pad there, just the beginnings of it. I'm going to have a new one of those. And let's see. All right, that's it. I'm out of time, and I will see you on the next one.